Movie lovers watching tomorrow night's showing of the classic Mr. Smith Goes to Washington might spend a moment or two thinking about a Memphis icon who's gone to Chicago.
The Mighty Wurlitzer from the Orpheum is being restored in an 18-month project that'll cost $500,000. But since it's one of only 12 Wurlitzers still in its original home, it is, in my opinion, money well spent, Kristin Bennett.
Absolutely.
And so most of the money has been raised. You still need a little bit of help from donors, right, who want to see the Wurlitzer back in its full glory?
Yes, absolutely. So we kicked off our Save the Wurlitzer campaign last summer.
Right.
And thanks to generous community support, a lead gift from the Plow Foundation, and just using some of our reserves,
yeah,
we have about $60,000 left, so okay, of that $500,000.
You're still passing the hat at the summer
movies?
Oh,
yes. Passing the bucket.
We got to do it. Kristin, for those who don't realize, what's the importance of the Wurlitzer? What's its history?
Oh, absolutely. It's 90 years old. It's as old as the Orpheum. And, you know, originally it was used, it was a vital piece of the theater. It was used to accompany silent movies and vaudeville. And like you said, it's only one of 12 that remain were originally installed. So it's an important piece of our history and definitely an important piece of Memphis history.
And the last time it was used was when?
For us, it was about last summer. We tried to use it for our holiday movie back in December, but unfortunately, time had taken its toll, so it's time for it to go and get restored.
Age catches up with all of us.
Oh, absolutely.
Even the Wurlitzer. So what was it like? We're showing some video. This is, because the public only sees really the keyboard as it rises up and it's played, but how many pieces, roughly?
There are lots of pieces. There are about 900 pipes,
which is
a lot more pipes than I thought. And then they have various instruments like the glockenspiel, the xylophone, because at one time, like I said, it was accompanying silent films, vaudeville, so it needed all those sound effects.
Will work again?
Yes.
The sound effect?
It'll be exactly like it played in 1928.
Oh, gosh, that's so cool.
It'll be great.
I want to hear the glockenspiel.
The organ itself, though, I can imagine, Kristin, is it almost like an actor, almost like a musician itself? Because it seems to be such an integral part of what goes on at the Orpheum.
Oh, definitely. I mean, I wish we played it more than, you know, when it was played back in the 90s, but surely when we get it back, we'll get to use it much more than the summer movie series. I forget who said it. It might have been Brett. It's the jewel in the Orpheum's crown. It's an important part of our building. So
I'm sure just not any organist gets to play it, right? Is an organ an organ, or does it take a certain kind of organist
We've
to play
had
this organ?
Just a handful.
Right.
Most recently, Tony Thomas, who's
he's been on the show a number of times.
He's been known to play during the summer movie series. Vincent Astor, local historian, has played it, and so we've had a handful. So
what do fans and patrons say about its sound? What does it mean to them? What have they told you guys?
Oh, they love it. I remember last summer movie series, I think, there was grandparents with their grandchildren, and they rushed them in, because we used to have a 10-minute concert before the movie, and so they rushed them in. They're like, you have to hear this played. And so it's an incredible sound, and you don't hear it that often.
No, you really don't.
You ought to hold a contest for people who do know how to play the organ.
Absolutely.
To be the first one to play her when she comes back.
That's a great idea.
Fundraiser, you got your $60,000
like
right there, girl. There you go. All right, so let us know next fall. It'll
be
back
fall 2019.
Okay.
She'll be back.
All right.
Okay, we cannot wait.
The Mighty Wurlitzer.
She'll be back home.
Ready.
Where she belongs. Kristin, thank you
the
very much.
The youngest 90-year-old ever.
That's right.
And she'll be looking good, too.
Oh, absolutely.
No doubt about it.